Hey there, in this video I'm going to cover how you can lose fat mass long term. So to lose fat you need to be in a calorie deficit. I'm sure you've heard that many times, but there can be misconceptions here when it comes to this. Half of the equation here is your total daily energy expenditure. So the three factors here are the calories you burn at rest, doing nothing, the calories you burn from the thermal effect of food, and the calories you burn through exercise. So in this video, we're gonna focus specifically on the calories you burn from exercise. So you're probably thinking now, to increase this number, just do hours of cardio each day. The problem here is if you haven't been doing any cardio at all, and then just go from doing hours of cardio each day, you're gonna be overtraining here. And this is going to lead to breaking down lean muscle mass, and having more lean muscle mass will increase that resting metabolic rate, which is the amount of calories you would burn doing nothing. So if you lose lean muscle mass because you're doing hours of cardio a day, in the long run, when you lose that lean muscle mass, your resting metabolic rate will decrease. So going from doing no cardio to hours of cardio a day is going to really hurt your progress here in the long run. So what you need to do here is not focus on how many calories you burn and how much weight you lose the first month. What you want to do here is you want to focus on training specific energy systems and increase in performance in those specific energy systems. So the first thing you need to do here is you need to increase your aerobic capacity. So how you improve this here is you need to be training at 59 to 74% of your one rep max. And I'll have a chart here to help you find this that's linked in the description. The next energy system you need to train is you need to increase your anaerobic capacity. So this right here is going to be at 85 to 93% of your VO2 max. So you need to train in this intensity, and then you need to train at 100% of your VO2 max. So to increase your aerobic base, we need progressive overload here. So if you haven't been doing any cardio at all, you need to start off here with like 10 minutes, 3 days a week, and then progressively increase here over time. You don't want to just go from doing zero cardio to 2 hours of cardio a day here, because if you think about it here, you aren't going to be training that energy system. At the end of that cardio session, you're going to be training more of your anaerobic capacity, because you don't have that aerobic base here, so you won't be capable of using oxygen. Now when it comes to training your anaerobic capacity, you want to train this for 20 to 30 minutes. But if you don't have that aerobic base built yet to train that long, then you just want to first only focus on your aerobic capacity, and you should only be training that energy system before you train your anaerobic capacity or VO2 max. First, focus on your aerobic base if you haven't done anything at all. But assuming you have an aerobic base built, you're able to walk or run for 30 minutes and not feeling like you're in that much pain, then you can train your VO2 max and anaerobic capacity. Now, when it comes to training your VO2 max, this is the pace that if you just went as hard as you could for 12 minutes and saw how much distance covered, that's gonna be your VO2 max pace. What will be effective here to train this energy system is do intervals. So do like 3 minutes on, 3 minutes off, and then repeat that 4 times here. So you do 3 minutes on, 3 minutes off, 3 minutes on, 3 minutes off, 3 minutes on, 3 minutes off, 3 minutes on, 3 minutes off. When you're doing 3 minutes on, you're going at your VO2 max pace. Then when you do your 3 minutes off, you'd go at your aerobic capacity pace. All right, so I know it's a lot of confusing information here, but to make things simple, focus on recovery. Focus on consistency and focus on recovery. Even if you don't keep track of what energy systems you're training, if you focus on consistently improving your cardio fitness But while at the same time giving yourself a chance to recover, and over a long period of time, increasing the pace and time you go, then you should see results here when it comes to fat loss in the long term. You'll be increasing your total daily energy expenditure in the long run here. Alright, so check out the description of the video for more information on specific energy systems and formulas, so you know what your aerobic base pace is, your anaerobic capacity pace is, and your VO2 max pace is. And then focus on training those energy systems, but don't do too much work here. I'll also lay out in the description how to know how often you should train each of those energy systems and how long you should train them at a time. All right, so if you found this video helpful, hit the like button. If you'd like to see more videos like this, subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comments.